Lesson 3, ways to access redistricting data. In this lesson, we will discuss the available methods you have to access redistricting data. Once you understand the format of the data in each of these methods, you can make a choice as to which of these methods meets your needs. We will also briefly discuss the additional resources you may need or find helpful to access these data. Because there are many ways to access redistricting data, and each of these ways has a different format and appeal, let's discuss each one so that you can choose your learning path to move forward accessing these data. The FTP is a great resource for those who want to perform in-depth analysis and customize their analysis of data sets. As for the format, when you select a state, you will be downloading all the files for every level of geography available within that state. The FTP is the only method to download the complete set of redistricting data files for each state. Downloading from the FTP is a multi-step process, and it requires the use of a statistical analysis software to extract the data. Pathway 1 will provide detailed instruction guiding you through how to download from the FTP step by step. For this method of data access, you may need some additional resources. Because there are four large files for each state that you will download, downloading and storing the redistricting data files from the FTP site will require computers with sufficient storage capacity. You will also need a software package that has the capability to extract the data from the FTP site, combining spatial and tabular data. There are several options, but R, SAS, and Microsoft Access are a few. If you would like to visualize your data on a map, you will need to download tiger line shapefiles from census.gov, and you can join the shapefiles with the data in a program, such as Maptitude, ArcGIS, or Tableau. Data visualizations are an excellent choice for someone who wants an easy and quick way to access the data and identify trends about a particular topic. Each of the 2020 Census redistricting data visualizations offers their own unique features and topics, such as population, race and ethnicity, voting age, and housing data. Some of them allow you to compare 2010 to 2020 Decennial Census statistics, and some focus on just one topic. Different from the FTP and data.census.gov, when accessing data from a visualization, you're only able to interact with the data while using the visualization, since in most cases, you cannot download the data. On the other hand, by visualizing the data on the map, it becomes easier to spot trends. Data.census.gov offers the most comprehensive method to access and use 2020 census data. It is a midway point between ease of use and the ability to download data. It gives you a customizable way to view, map, and access data one table at a time for all available geographies. Data.census.gov is the Census Bureau's centralized place to get demographic, housing, and economic data. Data are offered in a tabular format, but can also be viewed using a map. It allows you to select a variety of geographies for all 2020 census topics as individual tables. So this tool may be helpful if you're looking for a particular topic for specific geographies from the available redistricting data tables. You can easily view data from a mobile phone as well as a desktop. The Census API gives the public access to raw statistical data from various Census Bureau data programs. It enables developers to use our API to create and call customized data sets that feed into web or mobile applications. Many of our own Census Bureau tools and applications use our API. Data.census.gov is a great example of this. If you are interested in using redistricting data to learn about how your community has changed over time, between the 2010 and 2020 decennial censuses, my colleague Alexandra Barker has some critical information for you, including do's and don'ts, useful tips, and resources to utilize for how to approach looking for trends and changes while using these data. Let's check out what she has to say now.
Hi, I am Alexandra Barker. When trying to learn about how your community has changed over time, is it possible to compare redistricting data from the 2020 census with the 2010 census? Yes, you can make this comparison to assess trends and change in your area. However, it is important to understand the do's and don'ts when making a comparison. Tip number one, you can compare tables P1, P2, P3, P4, and H1 from the 2010 census and the 2020 census. These tables have the same data fields and universe. However, as part of the 2020 census redistricting data products, the Census Bureau released for the first time table P5 for group quarters population. In 2010, group quarters population by group quarters type was not released as part of the redistricting products. It was released with the main release of 2010 census data as table P42. Therefore, you can compare table P5 from 2020 with table P42 from the 2010 census. Tip number two, be cautious about the geographic area that you select for your comparison. It is critical that the boundaries for your area for the 2010 census and the 2020 census are the same. If the boundaries have changed from 2010 to 2020, the data for these areas should not be compared. Let me further explain this. Every decade, the Census Bureau redesigns the boundaries of blocks. Therefore, a direct block comparison is not advised. In addition, in order to provide privacy within the data at the block level, the Census Bureau applies noise to the data. So let me show you an example of a block boundary redesign. Let's check this map. On the first map, you can see the block boundaries for the 2010 census for an area in Massachusetts. Pay attention to the boundaries of the blocks 1004 and 1008. Now look at the same area for the 2020 census. Not only the block numbers have changed, but the two blocks from 2010 now form one block, number 1003. And the boundary between the old blocks 1008 and 1003 have changed, with one small part of the old block 1008 now being transferred to form the new block 1002. Although it is true that the tabulation block universes are not directly comparable from decade to decade, we included the 2010 to 2020 census tabulation block crosswalk file in the geographic support products to help states and the public understand the relationship between the 2010 and 2020 tabulation blocks. So this product makes some comparison possible in support of redistricting. So click on the link above on this video or on the description of the video to access the 2010 to 2020 census tabulation block crosswalk file. Tip number three, if you want to compare data over time for small areas, the census tract is a great geographic area. However, you also must make sure that the boundaries of the tracts that you are comparing remain the same between 2010 and 2020. Between censuses, the Census Bureau reviews the boundaries of the tracts to make sure that its population remains within the threshold of 1,200 to 8,000 people, with an optimum size of approximately 4,000 people. Tracts are often split or merged from the original tract boundaries, but let me show you this on a map. Let's say that between 2010 and 2020, the population grew in Census Tract 1701, and the census tract was subsequently split into two tracts in 2020. Each tract would get a suffix, 1701.01 and 1701.02. Although the original tract was a split, the combined boundaries of the two new tracts is still makes up the original boundary of tract 1701. This is why tract boundaries are recommended for temporal analysis. Tip number four,
Another option that's relatively consistent from decade to decade is counties. Even when working with higher levels of geography, such as counties and states, you need to make sure that their boundaries remain the same. Although it is more common to see an annexation process take place at a city or a town, it is possible, but less common, that annexation happens in a county or a state. States and counties can submit annexations and/or boundary corrections for counties through the annual boundary annexation survey. But the frequency and number of updates to county boundaries from decade to decade is small compared to updates submitted for other legal geographies, such as incorporated places. Tip number 5. Since it is necessary to review the geography boundaries before making a comparison, let me take you to Tiger Web Decennial for you to learn how to quickly determine if the boundaries for your area of analysis have changed.
To learn how to use Tiger Web Decennial, watch Census Academy's data gem, Can I Compare 2020 Census and 2010 Census Redistricting Data?
One of the best places to find resources and information on all 5 phases of the Redistricting Data program is their website. There, you can access the redistricting data files, technical documentation for how to access these data, and more. Alexandra will introduce you to several helpful resources on this webpage in part 2.
Here's what you have learned in lesson 3. You've learned your options for accessing redistricting data, and then learned a little bit about each source, and if there were any resources needed for downloading an analysis. Alexandra then discussed the do's and don'ts for comparison of 2010 and 2020 redistricting data. And finally, we discussed the Redistricting Data Program website as being a best source for more information. It's now time to pick one or more pathways. Which ones will you choose?